This video is brought to you by Setapp, the paramount collection of top-rated apps. A month ago, I showed you how I set up a new M1 Mac, including prepping and installing some of my go-to apps that go hand-in-hand with any new computer of mine. In continuation of this video, today I will show you some of my new app discoveries and potential candidates to join my list of evergreen recommendations. Most of these apps are paid and some of them are honestly quite expensive, but a bit further down the video, I'll show you how you can access almost all of them at a fraction of the cost. Hey, Iskren here, but feel free to call me E. Let's start with some productivity tools. The first one is called CleanShot X. The app replaces the default macOS screenshots capabilities, making them a lot more functional and frankly easier to use. The app lives in the menu bar in case you need to access it and uses the exact same macOS shortcuts like Command Shift 3 or 4. For starters, whenever a screenshot is taken, that screenshot doesn't go away after a few seconds, giving me time to choose if I actually want to keep it or do something more specific with it, like markup or my absolute favorite area pixelation. Before, if I wanted to hide some sensitive information, I would have to open the screenshot in a more advanced photo editing app, and such quick mask would have taken longer than it should. With CleanShot X, I can do that in seconds and it's a lot of fun. The behavior of the app is very simple, making the entire experience a joy, like adding multiple shapes and arrows, for example. Also with it, video screen recording is a breeze, and something that I've been missing for the longest of time is here, and that's the ability to record GIFs. Or GIFs. Basically, any portion of my screen can become a GIF, allowing me to create the animated frame-by-frame image on top of any content, like a grab from a video or just a simple instructional movement. Crazy useful for tutorial website content. That's not all. With CleanShot X, I can also capture scrollable content like a long conversation, for example, or a website. This is a bit tricky because it is basically making multiple screenshots that it stitches together, and the precision relies on the smoothness of your scrolls, but it is definitely a huge time saver. As I go along, I'll put a simple calculation in the corner showing you how much each of those apps cost and how much you can potentially save at the end. This particular app that we just talked about is normally sold for $29. To spice the list up a bit, let's deviate for a second and talk about a very relaxing and pleasant to use app called Magic Window Air, which is actually a screensaver. The app works like any other screensaver and can take you to over 200 aerial locations, showcasing spectacular 4K aerial shots totaling more than 4 hours of footage. From Alabama Hills to Big Sur and Zion, it is definitely my new favorite screensaver. Flying around the historic casino ballroom in Avalon. Nice. Think of it more like Apple TV's screensaver, but on a Mac. You can actually customize it a little bit more by adding a clock and even your own videos, which gives me ideas to dust off my DJI Mavic this time around. This app is around 20 bucks. Espresso is my next app on the favorites list, which is a web editor for Mac. It is very powerful, yet very minimal and easy to use. It has everything I might need when it comes to HTML and CSS tasks, and what I enjoy most of it is how well it mimics and integrates into macOS. The left side is my asset management, the code is in the middle, and navigation on the right. It is ideal for any new project because it saves tons of time by providing boilerplate information necessary to start a new project or page. Live preview when editing is greatly appreciated as well, since I don't need to tap back and forth between the app and my browser, which probably at the end of the day I will still do because I need to cross-browser test. Anyway, Espresso runs for a one-time purchase of $99. Let's talk about file sizes and two optimizing applications which work fantastic. First off, there is Squash. Squash is an image optimizer that can reduce the file sizes of pretty much all popular formats in a beautiful manner. Having the proper size image file is not only good for optimizing storage, but it's sometimes important for work as well. For example, YouTube thumbnails should not exceed 2 megabytes in a file size, whether that's JPEG or PNG. And with Squash, it's a matter of dragging and dropping the file to reduce it to a whopping 40%, or even smaller, without any visible loss of quality when we talk about JPEGs. Next up is PDF Squeezer, which serves similar purpose like Squash but for PDFs. Depending on your preferences, you can easily reduce a PDF file size just by dragging a file into the clean interface of the app and get results as good as 90% reduction. Of course, all file savings are based on how bad the embedded images will look, but I would definitely classify this app as a huge time saver. The alternative, of course, would be to use macOS's native preview, but it's not as quick to use and it may become a bit cumbersome at times. PDF Squeezer is normally around 11 euros or $13, and Squeeze is another 15 bucks. Textsniper has been a channel sponsor before, and it is perhaps the app of the year for me. It is a text recognition software that lives in your menu bar and can be triggered by using the shortcut Command-Shift-2, which brings the crosshair, the cursor, ready to take a screenshot of any text, image, video, scan document, pretty much anything that has text baked into it. With this app, you have the ability to convert any text, for example, taking a picture of an entire book page, and convert your photo into ready-to-copy and paste selectable text. Textsniper is criminally cheap, coming to you at around 7 bucks. Luminar is the next app that I'd like to turn your attention to. This is version 4, not to be confused with Luminar AI, which is a lot simpler app. Luminar 4 is amazing because it offers a complete image library and photo editing solution, sort of like Lightroom, where you have your library of images and tools to manipulate them with. Just like Luminar AI, it allows you to create some really magical, fake, yet real looking results that would make even the dullest photo look out of this world. With powerful AI enhanced tools like sky replacement, object add-ons, and plenty of other more professional controls, the sky is the limit. Luminar normally costs around $100. So far, if we look at the calculations, we are at a bill of $282.99 for the apps that I have listed, and I'm not even done yet. But instead of paying almost 300 bucks at this point, you can use today's video sponsor Setapp, which is an app curator that gives you access to the above listed tools and over 200 others for a monthly subscription fee of $9.99. Think of Setapp as your app store, but subscription based, giving you the option to install and remove flagship apps at your convenience without having to risk and spend extra on software that you might not like. With Setapp, you can install as many apps as you want. And what I like most is how easy it is to install and remove an app, all with a single click of a button. Each of the applications on Setapp are carefully curated by the platform and are of great value to those who need them. So check out the first link in the description below to sign up for Setapp's free trial. The next app that I want to talk about today is called Short Menu. This is a very simple yet powerful app that lives in the menu bar again and helps me shorten URLs. My favorite part of this is that I can do that automatically. Here's how it works. Let's say I want to share a news article to someone. Normally, I would select the URL and paste it, which is exactly the case with Short Menu, but notice what happens when I paste the URL. It shortens it automatically, which is great. Imagine preparing a document where you have dozens of links. You know how messy things might get. Well, not anymore. Short Menu can also work with popular shortening services like Bitly, so it definitely stays on my list. Short Menu costs around $8.50, and I think it's worth every penny on its own. Mindnode is an app that I had purchased myself long time ago, and it is something that for some reason I totally forgot about. While prepping this video, I reminded myself why I invested in this tool in the first place way back when. Mindnode is a mind mapping and brainstorming software that helps me organize any ideas. Throughout the years, I had used it on numerous occasions to illustrate the journey of a project to clients, but it's just as good to be used for personal projects as well. When you throw all your ideas into Mindnode, including the minute details, your perspective changes because you can truly grasp the potential of something. Mindnode is subscription-based and usually it's around $2.50 per month. So if I throw in my other favorite apps that I talked about in my How I Set Up My Mac video, like Bartender, Clean My Mac X, and others, my bill can easily exceed $500. When I put it like that, knowing how much I have invested throughout the years in apps and software, I feel kind of sad not having found Setapp earlier. So, which are your favorite app discoveries? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to list them in the comments or ping me on Twitter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.